events were driving King toward more radical solutions. Some proposed marching the poor to the nation's capital to force government action on the problems of poverty. In August, Marion Wright took the idea of a poor people's march on Washington to her friend, Martin King.
He immediately understood that it was right, we chatted a bit about how it would be done, but there was never any discussion about whether that was the right thing to do.
So when he came home that evening, he was real excited, you know, about this idea of a poor people's campaign starting in Marks, Mississippi, with a mule train and going all the way to Washington, D.C., picking up people along the way.
The campaign would recruit among all races, bring them to Washington, commit massive civil disobedience, force the government to respond, a nonviolent army of the poor.
Now, very frankly, this is a search for an alternative to riots. And if the nation doesn't respond to us, as we labor that 2 or 3 months, however long it takes, God only knows what we will face in terms of chaos. This is a kind of last desperate demand for the nation to respond to nonviolence.